me thank everyone for coming today to join us in that first meeting that we're going to be doing throughout the world. And thank you, Jeannette, for taking the opportunity to actually join us in that meeting. So this is a fantastic time for the business school. We're in a great state. We're moving into a new campus in 2 years, and hopefully all of you will be joining us in about 27 months when we move to Manhattanville. And we have some very interesting things that we want to pursue in the future. Business is undergoing change. The types of jobs that MBA students are taking are changing. So this is a time for us to innovate. I'm going to focus on just four things, and I'm going to try to be brief. The first and foremost priority for us is really to continue changing the curriculum that we offer at the school to essentially best prepare our students for the digital future. Our careers are changing, and we need to continue to evolve the type of courses that we offer and the type of experiential opportunities that we offer to our students to essentially simulate and bring to bear the types of things that we teach in the class in actual projects sponsored by firms so that they actually get to experience and integrate the type of knowledge that we're giving the courses before they actually go out to work. So this is sort of the most important thing that we need to do is really to provide excellent education to our students and alums, and that's going to be the primary focus of what we're going to be doing. We're starting already. The second thing that we're going to do is we're going to take essentially all of this innovation that we have in the curriculum and we're going to turn it around and offer it online. It's through sort of some kind of technological offering to our alums. So we're going to be launching a lifelong learning initiative. Thank you.
That sounds great. I think the alumni should especially be happy to hear about the lifelong learning, flipping it around, because there's opportunities to learn about new tech and new quantitative methods that perhaps weren't available when they were students here. So that's great.
The third thing, which relates to Jeannette and the university more broadly, is we're going to deepen our relationships with other units of the university, data science, engineering, but medical school, essentially create either curricular or programmatic efforts wherever it makes sense. And then the second thing is to pursue sort of truly ambitious cross-disciplinary research initiatives. These are things that the business school should be trying to do, but the business school alone cannot solve these problems. These problems are too big, and we need to collaborate with engineers, with data scientists, statisticians, economists, sociologists, legal scholars. Jeannette and I, and all of you as part of our family, we're fortunate to be part of an amazing institution that has experts in every discipline, and we need to bring that to bear. Okay. The last thing I'm going to say that I think the business school should do is we should play really a leadership role in entrepreneurship at the university. So we should be, and we could be, the hub of all entrepreneurial activity at the university at large. I mean, what we have at the business school is human capital. Okay, we have hundreds of students every year that are eager to engage and sort of help commercialize ideas that are being generated either at the business school or throughout the university. And you know, we should be able to put that human capital essentially to work.
Let's go back to another priority of yours that you mentioned, which is collaborating across the university. Of course, I'm happy to be a collaborator with you. What kind of interdisciplinary programs do you imagine being able to put into place, either in education or in research?
So let me just go back to that visual of the data scientists and the MBA students, right? So I think the first thing that we should be doing is we should offer more integrative courses where we put data scientists and engineers together in the room with MBA students We have a pipeline of projects coming from companies or alums that we bring to the school, and they work on analytics projects jointly. They learn how to collaborate in a team environment. This is good for the business school students. This is good for the data scientists. And they solve some sort of applied business problems. Something that I want to pursue, and I think this is something that Jeannette has been trying for the last 2 years to pursue as well in Data Science Institute, and we've been talking for a long time about these things, is to bring researchers together from across the university to really attack big problems. So the business school should do it in areas where we have something to contribute. But, you know, let's pick climate, okay? We happen to have at the business school some amazing, amazing researchers that work on climate. But clearly, we're not going to solve that problem in the business school, okay? That's much bigger than us. But we should create a forum where we bring our own researchers. We should bring people from engineering, let's say, to tell us about carbon capture and clean energy and batteries. The business ecosystem of New York has been diversifying rapidly in the last decade or so. I want to see ourselves as a school that essentially is, at some level, provides the best possible education in this sort of digital future across industries, not finance focused or only in that area, but across areas, and leveraging essentially the diversity of the business landscape here in New York to sort of create to achieve that goal. That's, I think, we are uniquely positioned to actually succeed in that. I mean, every other top school happens to be in an inferior geography in terms of what they have within sort of walking distance or subway distance from their campus.